Hello and welcome to this short demonstration of the PATS dashboard. The PATS dashboard, it's a web application, is a visualization of data collected by the PATS cameras, which are used in greenhouse settings. In this environment, they monitor the activity of airborne pest insects like moth. So when you go to this web application and we log in with our demo account, then we can quickly select one of our customers. We have, of course, anonymized the data, for which we will then get the data that has been collected by the systems installed there. In this case, we are looking at a gerbera grower. The size of the greenhouse is 5 hectares, and in this environment, we have placed 5 camera systems. We're looking at data from June 1st, so this summer, until last night. This data is already available. And then specifically we're zooming in on the tomato looper pest, or in Dutch, Turks and moth. So what do we see in the dashboard? Well, the first graph is actually the most important. This shows the flight activity of the adults. So that's one of the 4 life stages of this pest. We're looking at the flight activities, and which we measure every night, during the whole night. So in this case, when we look at September 26th, we now are zooming in on system 3. That's all 31 adult moth passing the camera. But all these 5 systems together, hence the 5 different colors, has seen 432 tomato loopers pass the system. And looking at this flight activity is actually a great way to show how the pest is developing, because you can actually see the different generations follow up each other. In this case, I'm showing an extreme example, but it gives a very good visualization of how powerful it can be to monitor these kinds of pests on a daily basis, and how we are, for example, able to see pest insects up to 5 weeks earlier than conventional methods. So here we see the data from day to day, and then we can plot the trends, but we're also doing a little bit more than that. And we're also looking at all this data collected here, and then we're looking at, okay, which hours is this specific moth active? And then we see some interesting facts, and they differ per moth, because we always thought moths are nocturnal, which is true, but they have a very preferred time of flying. So in case of gerberas, and where the greenhouse is always darkened more or less around 6 o'clock in the evening, also in summer, we see that the tomato looper has a strong preference to fly in the early hours of the night. 80 of 90% of the flight activity happens between 6 and, let's say, 9-ish, 10 in the evening. And so that is quite a helpful insight. This data is also collected on a daily basis, because we have different times of when the shades close or when the sun up goes under or up. But we can show this also on a daily basis. So, for example, last night, between 5 and 6, we saw that there were 29 moths passing our 5 monitoring systems. Well, this data, this is coming from something. It's just not simple counts. But if you make a selection in this data, we can actually see where it's coming from. And I've selected a few hundreds of moth flights. I go down to the bottom, and here they are. And we measure all kinds of different characteristics, like the size, the flight path, the speed. And that we use to train our models and to actually put a label on the insect and say, hey, here we're looking at a tomato looper, or here we're looking at, for example, Tuta absoluta or Tuta julia. So we're looking at a number of detections, which I just selected. And now I'm going to just select one of the detections we did. Here, this one, for example, coming from system 5, shot at in the night of the 1st of November, a little bit before 7 in the evening. When I select it, it's now retrieving the video on demand from the system that's actually in that greenhouse. Then we see this flight path. It's a little bit wicked, perspective from the camera. But more important, here we can see the moth actually flying through the view, making its way through the gerbera crops, which you can see here, and then disappearing above the camera again. And so every detection that we do, every detection that we make, can be led back to an individual passing the system, which makes it great for validation, but also means that we can separate insects. This data is collected, obviously, to train our models, as we see much more than moths. But we also see other airborne insects. And yeah, it's our mission to add those insects to the dashboard. Not only those that are active at night, but also those that are active on the day. Not only those that are harmful, but also beneficial insects. Well, this is just a glance of the PATS dashboard. I think it gives a clear picture of what it is, what it does, and how it can be valuable to you. If you have any questions, drop us a message, a mail, or call us, and we're happy to help you out. Thank you very much.